we turn our attention to a pitcher's biggest fear, the comebacker. So how much force was behind what happened to Bryce Flory on September 8th, 2000? To find out, we turn back to Crash and once again put him in harm's way. But standing in for a pitcher, Crash won't have the protection of a batting helmet. Now our scientists need to figure out how fast to crank up the pitching machine. To do this requires understanding the physics of a collision. Upon impact, a bat actually flexes and, like a slingshot, sends the ball back faster than it was thrown. Our scientists calculate that the line drive that struck Bryce Flory was traveling 120 miles an hour. That's 30% faster than the beanball. So will the comebacker generate 30% more force? As we replicate the precise conditions of Bryce Flory's accident, Crash will find out.
Fire in the hole!
So how much force did this hit generate? The beanball, traveling at 95 miles an hour, generated 2,400 pounds of force. But the comebacker, traveling 30% faster at 120 miles an hour, slams into an unprotected head with an astonishing 5,500 pounds of force, over twice as much force generated by the beanball. This is enough force to stop a Mini Cooper moving at 10 miles an hour dead in its tracks. So how quickly did Bryce have to react? Our motion tracking technology breaks down the scariest moment in baseball. Flory's follow-through leaves him only 55 feet from home plate. From the instant the ball is struck, leaving the bat at 120 miles an hour, Flory has only 312 milliseconds to react. As the image of the ball enters his eye, it's broken down into electrical impulses. The brain takes 110 milliseconds to decode this data, but as the ball travels the last 15 feet toward his head, the brain and the eyes cannot work together fast enough, and the ball is essentially invisible. In Bryce Flory's case, at the moment of bat-to-ball contact, his glove was waist-high and had to travel 26 vertical inches to impede the path of the ball. Even the slightest deflection could have saved his face, but he can't react in time.